Good afternoon, friends. We have got Harry Stinson today from Stinson Hotels. We're going to be discussing something really exciting today with him. He's got obviously a lot of milestone projects in Toronto to his credit, and now he's working in Hamilton, but now we're going to US and looking at some landmark projects with him today, which are great investment opportunities for a lot of Canadian investors looking other side of the border, not only to kind of invest but also travel and use them at times. But here we are with something which is remarkable, and Harry's going to talk to us about that, which is the train station project.
Everybody calls it the train station.
Okay, let's discuss that. So what is the project? What do you call it? Why you call it so? And what is the potential for investment? We'll discuss that further out as well. So
why do we call it the train station? Because it is. I mean, if you're familiar with Union Station in Toronto, or to be more exact, Grand Central Station in New York, the Buffalo train station is exactly the scale of Grand Central New York, built by the same train organization, same scale, same architects. It's in this enormous Art Deco train station, just sitting just outside of the core of downtown Buffalo. It's been abandoned for 40 years. It's a 16-acre parcel of land, a million square feet of the whole complex. And I've acquired it from the city of Buffalo to completely rebuild, and we're putting a hotel conference center with lofts and offices. It's a whole village, really, on its own. But I think what the really exciting thing is the price, which is $99,000. Canadian, by the way.
Okay, that's
Canadian
good.
It's very important. $99,900 for a fully furnished hotel suite within this business complex. So what an investor gets essentially is part ownership in a hotel business. But it gets a little more interesting because obviously the architecture of the train station itself is appealing. Just look at the pictures and it's a wow building. It needs a lot of work, but it's a wow building. What we've done to really make it understandable and stable is we blended it with another hotel, which we're also acquiring in Buffalo, which is the former Buffalo Hilton downtown. It is right there. If you're going on the 190 in downtown Buffalo, it's right there. It's where you could reach out and touch the building. It's the largest conference hotel in Western New York. It's 484 rooms, 72,000 square feet of convention space. And it's right there. You could walk to the hockey arena, you can walk to City Hall, you can walk to the convention space. It's about as good a location as you can get for a hotel. And we're acquiring it for the very simple reason is that it's a huge event hotel that is a bit tired. And that happens in the hotel business. And that's what I love, these opportunities. To take something and make it over. It's what I did with One King West, it's what we did at the Candy Factory, it's what we did at Stinson School. For 35 years I've been finding essentially grand white elephant buildings, orphans, that have sort of lost their way into it and putting them back to life. So we're acquiring this huge hotel downtown, which is operating now. And that's the solid thing about it. I can show you the performance today. I can show an investor exactly what's coming out of that existing hotel. And that will generate a 15% return for them.
Well, that's
from day one. And we're giving them a fixed guaranteed return of 5%. We're leasing the suite back from the investor. So essentially, this is the three parts to it. They own a suite in the hotel, $99,900. It's fully furnished. It's Canadian $99,900, so they're already
supported.
It's good because the revenues are coming in America. Okay. They own a suite. We lease it back from them for a 5% net return. So a $100,000 suite, they're getting $5,000 right off the top net. No condo fees, no taxes, nothing. We lease it back at a net 5% guaranteed return. We then split half the profits with them. So they're going to be looking at another $5,000 to $10,000 in the distributions from the events and the hotel rooms and buildings. So they're now looking at $15,000 a year on the hotel. This is just from the existing hotel. You then add the train station, and as you can see from the images, it's a spectacular space. There's nothing like this in the Golden Horseshoe. All those revenues are on top of that. But this is a completely unprecedented project. There's no building like this that I know of in North America that is of this scale, an actual formal train station that has been dedicated now to an event center. Not just to, you know, occasionally have an event there. This is a full-scale operation. Those revenues come on top of the existing hotel. There's proven revenue, there's projected future activity, and they actually own the real estate. It's not a timeshare, it's not a fractional, it's not a shell game. This is an actual ownership of real estate. And as you said, you can stay there, you get a free day a year, you have an account at the hotel, you want to call the concierge and say, you know, I need some tickets to the Sabres game.
That's Sweet.
No problem. You're a hotel owner. You can come. This is a neat part of an investment. You own a mutual fund. What do? You sit at home and you worry. You know?
Absolutely.
If you own this hotel room, you can come and sit in the lobby of the hotel and watch people come in. Watch them putting money in your pocket. As they go to the front desk, you say, yes. You know, if they sit at the bar in the lobby, yes, for me. Or you can run an account there and just enjoy it.
Well, that's great. Like you mentioned signature project you did, like One Key Invest, and
yes.
I think everybody talks about or raves about it in a way. I think investors there who jumped in there got really kind of huge returns, and probably you may want to refer to a few of those kind of like returns, how they can like expect it, like
well,
is it going to those same lines?
There's one other thing that I forgot to mention. This is RSP or TFSA eligible. So you can actually take your RSP money to acquire this hotel suite and get the revenue from it back in your RSP or into your TFSA. So that's the another important component of it. And for we're finding most of the people who are buying these are using their RSP TFSA.
Well, that's excellent.
We only released it a few days ago, and I've already had over 300 people registered on it.
Wow.
So this is a scramble.
So it's almost like you mentioned like 484 rooms.
484 rooms, and that's it. If you can't add rooms, that's it. 484.
That's great.
So it's going to go very quickly. We're just releasing the documents now. We're we'll organize presentations. We'll have an event. People want to come to them. They can hammer me with the questions. You know, this is very real.
That's really it is. I mean, it's pretty much no brainer. We understand like there are condo hotels that are coming over even in our own city, like Trump Tower, for example. We have a million dollar price tag attached to that.
Okay, and that's an important point, is that this is viable.
Yes.
I mean, I've been in the hospitality business since I was 17, so that is far too many years, but two generations ago, I'm in my 60s now. I love the hotel business, I love the hospitality business. Trump Tower type of building, it has a great name. Depending on your opinion there, it has a known name, shall we say. But $1 million for a hotel suite is ridiculous. You can't possibly make a return on it. At $100,000, you can. Plus, what was missing in that model, and is missing in most models, and One King West is the only one, because we deliberately structured it for the owners, is the only one that works. Because what happens there is all the revenue from the whole building. And I don't mean the revenue from your suite. I mean the revenue from everybody's suite. I mean the banquet revenue, the parking revenues, every movies on demand, the cell phone tower on the roof. Every single dollar that comes into the hopper gets spread out amongst all the owners. So there's no worry about did they use my suite, did they charge more, did they charge less, the favoritism, the manager's taking the cream of the money, they're giving me a little bit. All of that money is distributed. It's an even audited distribution every quarter. So you know what you're getting, and there's no, again, going back to the condo hotel model, there is no real one model. What you generally have, more commonly, you have a building, the condo is at the top, the hotel is at the bottom, people come in and they stay at the hotel. People buy a condo upstairs and somehow think that they're getting revenue from the hotel, and they're not. But they didn't read the documents. They just saw a condo hotel. There's the building. There's a fancy picture. I'm in. Read the darn thing. It never said, in the case of the Trump Tower, it did not say you're getting money. It said you're in the same building. That's it. Sorry, what? But people got caught up in the excitement. In the One King model, in the Buffalo Central Terminal model, which is even better, it is a complete consolidated revenue stream. There's no distraction. There's no competition. And I don't have to emphasize that. You are in an organized business. You cannot buy this condo and lease it on your own. You cannot put it on Kijiji. You cannot put it on Airbnb. All of the money comes into one pot. And that's important because when you have people doing it on their own, that's what they do. They put it on Kijiji. They cut the rate a little bit. They don't put in the same quality furniture. They don't provide the service. They don't provide the security. That undermines the brand standard, undermines the rates, undermines the distribution. Now less people are carrying all the costs and less money. We make sure that every nickel that comes into that building is split amongst the investors evenly.
That's really wonderful. I mean, this is quite a concept, and I think
it's a dictatorship. It's a business.
No, it is great. I mean, end of the day, everybody wants managed services, and I think that's going to build the brand as well as keep people coming back.
Exactly. The brand is critical.
Absolutely.
Our brand is WOW Buildings. And that's why One King has done well. And it's an interesting point. One King West is non-branded. There's no Sheraton, Hilton name on it. It is an independent 574-suite boutique hotel, which is saying quite a lot. If you're booking a wedding at One King, which is difficult, by the way, you're paying more than you are the Ritz-Carlton. Why?
Yeah.
Because
it's
of the character of the building. Because it's a one of a kind.
It is.
And it has. And when we started, and I started up One King from scratch, and I set up my own hotel company, I actually found that we were performing better without being a brand. There's nobody in head office telling us what to do. You know, our ability to buy was flexible. We didn't have to buy this kind of towel. We didn't have to do that. We didn't have to get tied into corporate. We could respond, turn on the dime. You know,
right.
Our rates were set based on the character and quality of the building. And I don't do boring. I do flamboyant stuff.
Excellent.
Maybe that's why I belong in the States.
You know what? I mean, but Canadians love you as well. Of course, we've seen all the success with the One King
West
project as well. And we know that we
have. I've had my girl.
I know, but you're doing great again. Like with a lot of good projects, you're saying definitely in Hamilton as well.
Hamilton's coming alive.
It definitely is. And you know what? Everybody's now, I mean, saying it is the very next stop to Toronto, is probably the next one in terms of the rate of returns. Plus, also, people looking from cash flow standpoint, Hamilton has been always a dark horse. It is coming out live now. And this is not far from even Hamilton, if you will. I mean, Buffalo, you are originally, I mean, an hour drive from Toronto, or maybe a little bit, few more minutes. You can go watch a game, and you can still kind of come back after a day trip if you like, but you can stay over even better if you want to see. If you buy one, and you're lucky to buy one, I would say that if you already have 300 people lined up.
Well, we have the registration. We haven't even signed the documents yet. We're just starting as we've been today. You know, I don't know when this is going to go live, but, you know, as
soon.
Okay, so what are we, 19th today?
Absolutely, it's 20th already.
20th,
that's
flies.
Absolutely.
We only put this out this weekend.
Excellent.
15th and 16th, and we're already flooded with them. So time is a critical factor.
Absolutely. So what's next in terms of from an investor standpoint? Obviously, you shared numbers high level, but there is some performance statements.
We do have.
The
fine print,
as you mentioned, is important. You're right, exactly sure.
I need to read it.
Absolutely.
Well, yes, what we'll provide people with is summary of the building, images of both buildings themselves, how it functionally works, the operational program, an example pro forma of just the phase one revenue, which is just the hotel itself, before we get into the train station. But the phase one revenue itself is 15%.
Wow.
And the documents, the signature document, which is quite simple. It's only 6 pages. Letter size, legible type, you know, it's a revolutionary concept. It's very simple, but they can register. I trust you'll have a contact on the video there that people can contact you.
That out there on
and
the screen,
you know, hopefully we'll set up an event and people can come to it. But I would say don't wait.
Definitely.
Contact right away and we'll get this. It's all electronic anyways. Everybody just wants to get an email.
Absolutely. Wait, this morning's one year as well to cool off like the Toronto market and they're talking Golden Horseshoe and all that. A lot of opportunities there now to kind of turn to the cash flow opportunities. People have been looking at the equity gains. So as in the Toronto and GTA area probably now, that's going to put a little bit damper. We'll see how it kind of pans out. But apart from that, I think a lot of people have made some equity and gains there in the Toronto real estate market.
Cash out now.
And I think it's an opportunity to put it towards the cash flow game now. That's where it is. And I think this is putting your starting point is not too high, as you mentioned, as compared to other projects.
99 Canadian.
And you know what? They're, this is a signature project in itself. I think, as you mentioned, it was a previous hotel, which is also Hilton brand.
It was built as a 5-star Hilton, and you know that was in the past. And it just, you know, sometimes hotels get into a, you know, a lazy phase, and they don't keep up with the Joneses. And if you don't do that, you know, someone has to come along and do it. And that's what I like. I like the makeovers. And I only found this hotel by accident.
Well, that's a good accident to have.
But that's what life is like, you know? With all the plans, they didn't work out, but the accidents, you know?
You always favor the ones
you
are looking for.
You've got to recognize them.
Absolutely. And that's wonderful. You had a story also about this train station project itself. I mean, you grabbed it for, like, I think, probably $50.
It was $2.
Wow.
But that was $2 American, so you know, there's
that's expensive still.
But the reason for that is this is what in the States they have called something called the National Registry. The National Registry is historic buildings that are so important that you can't touch them, and so we satisfied the government of the United States, from the city to the state, right up to the Secretary of State for the Interior. You have to satisfy them that you are a worthy custodian of this National Registry building. So it wasn't about the price. I mean, this is an enormous building where the restoration costs are going to be significant. Their concern was, will this new owner satisfy the requirements? We have to actually go to them and say, here's our renovation plan. It gets as detailed as the light fixtures, the kind of carpet, who's involved, have they done this before? You have to prove that you are worthy of this building. So the transfer was not about the money. The transfer is about, are we the right people to do the building? And so I put together a really strong team. Our general manager, for example, Steve Fitzmaurice, I mean, one of the buildings he ran was the Waldorf Astoria in New York. The New York Hilton as well, when he worked for Hilton, that's 2,000 rooms. Ran Los Angeles Hilton. I mean, he's right up there in terms of understanding these buildings. And as he mentioned once to me, they were doing a renovation of the Waldorf Astoria while they were open. So they had the scaffolding set up in the ballroom, they take it down, they do a wedding, they put the scaffolding back up for the day. You know, he's been through this before. Another fellow I have, Doug Swift, as my builder contact on, he just finished doing a project in Buffalo called Riverworks. And if you Google the Buffalo Six Pack, you'll see this image of these grain silos on the waterfront of Buffalo that they painted blue like a Blavat Six Pack. Yeah. And they have a brewery inside there. And he has a restaurant beside it that will accommodate 5,000 people. It has a roller rink, it has two skating rinks. It's like an incredible complex right on the waterfront of Buffalo, like the docks in Toronto.
Oh, yes.
And Doug just set this up. You know, so these are very, you know, specifically targeted people. Our architects, they're the leading architects in historic restoration. I put together a really good team down there. I'm just the crazy with the ideas. They execute.
And that's the important part. I mean, a lot of people come with a lot of funny ideas at times, and they're entertaining, of course, but at the same point in time, they don't make you money.
Oh,
but you have proven it to the different, like,
bars and coffee shops of the world are full of people with great ideas.
Absolutely.
And that's where it ends.
And that's where it's a teamwork.
Yeah.
And we definitely would love to be part of that team, and really proud of that, like, sitting with today and trying to kind of kickstart this initiative, and coming over as one of the first opportunities, if you will, to come to the people and investors.
Interview we've done.
Absolutely. And it's a pleasure and honor to sit down with you, and especially with the portfolio that you have developed over the years. I think you're going to make also kind of a private once you're on the other side of the border. And now
I'm keeping my Canadian passport. I do have
that's
U.S.
Good.
Citizenship now.
We
want sometimes you want to wave the Canadian passport. Here's where you are.
That's a great country, and why not? We make some money out there in American dollars.
And the healthcare is free here. So.
Oh, absolutely. We have a great country and great things going for us. But at the same point in time, never hurts making some American dollars.
Absolutely. Bring those dollars
and
home.
And we're here this round and get our money stronger.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thank
I look
you
forward to get this message out to our investors and have an event that we're going
to
do together.
And they need
and,
to understand the urgency.
Absolutely. And we'll share that, of course, as well in the message.